Next, please join me in welcoming the St. John's Area School Board Chair, Becky Baldock, as she delivers some remarks to the graduates.
Good evening. It's a true honor for me to be here. I've been here a few times before. It's very honorable, very honorable. 31st President Herbert Hoover once said, "Children are our most valuable resource." Today is one of those great occasions when we get to celebrate our children, their achievements, their perseverance, and their successes as they grow up. It's one of the times we can take a break to reflect, feeling good as a parent or a mentor, knowing that these kids, our kids, are on the right path. Graduates, you should know that your parents are very proud of you today. They have high hopes for you, and they believe in you. You're making them proud by showing them what you can do. Take a look at them now. See them smiling and snapping photos so that they can record this moment forever. Today is an important day for you and for them. Today, they are very, very proud. Graduates, today would be a good day to ask for money. Today would also be a good day to hug them and thank them for supporting you, because as much as this is your achievement, this is theirs. Your family, friends, and teachers want you to be your best and live up to your full potential. Graduations can be seen as a coming of age, a sort of official way to recognize when a person steps into the next stage of life. As you graduate today, you are stepping into a new stage. You've had some great times through the years, and maybe you've had some tough times, but you did it. Here you are. You succeeded. You're ready for the next step. I ask that you prepare for this next step to do a few things. First, live and seek out experiences outside of technology. Technology is wonderful, a very useful thing, but please remember that it should enhance your life, not run it. I myself, a wannabe photographer, realize that I often miss out on an experience as a whole because I am so focused on getting the perfect shot. I live my life looking only at what the lens allows me to see instead of all that's around me. At times when I force myself to leave my camera at home, I have found that I actually enjoyed myself more by being able to take it all in. According to life coach Martin Beck, she says, basic human contact, the meeting of the eyes, the exchanging of words, is to the psyche what oxygen is to the brain. If you're feeling abandoned by the world, interact with anyone you can. So I challenge you, put your phones, iPads, and cameras down once in a while and have face-to-face conversations. Explore the world yourself. Don't watch someone else explore it on a small screen. Actually, hang out with your friends instead of just texting so that you can hear them laugh and laugh with them, instead of just reading LOL. Secondly, I ask you to take this chance to dedicate yourself to making the next year even better than this one. Remember that you don't have to follow the crowd. Do the right thing, even if no one else is looking. Study hard, and remember that you're investing in yourself with every test you take and every book that you read. And finally, don't be in too big of a hurry to grow up. These are some great times in your life. Don't rush past them. After all, you only have one childhood. Enjoy it. Your awesomeness is shining and your future is bright. Just as your families and teachers are proud, each one of you should be proud of yourself. So congratulations, class of 2017. Congratulations to the parents and families. And finally, congratulations to the teachers and everyone else who helped our graduates get here today. I'll leave you with this final quote from a great author with whom I imagine you all are familiar with, by the name of Theodore Seuss Geisel, also known as Dr. Seuss. "You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. You are the guy who will decide where you go." Congratulations again, class of 2017.
Emma Powers. She is going to be doing it today.
Yay!
end of 2016-2017. My name is Emma Power, and I wanted to start off by just saying thank you for coming out tonight on such a special evening. Whether your child walked through those doors 10 years ago from preschool with a small mind, or walked in here just 3 months ago and grabbed their parents for making them leave their old school, we have all been a part of the St. John's Ray School family. This school has been a stepping stone in all of our lives, but sadly, as this chapter closes, many of us look forward to the challenges that lie ahead, new experiences to be shared, and new friendships to be forged. I would personally like to thank the administration, school board members, teachers, staff, volunteers, and parents for their time to better prepare me and the class of 2017 for what lies ahead.
Thank you.
Next, we welcome the St. John's Ferry School Middle School faculty and the Unified Arts teachers to present the awards.
This year's band award is presented to an 8th grade instrumental music student that is a positive role model for the band members and exemplifies this through their daily rehearsals and performance. This award is presented to Jonah Plazek.
Second recipient is Mr. Cale McGinnis. held by the former principal, James King. I'm proud to present these awards to Fabrizio Davis Jr., Lucy Shattuck, and Kobe Sol Cruz.
Yeah. What a wonderful world. things on the class record, but I'm not going to talk about public things today. For the most amazing thing that she has done for 42 years is to teach children how to read. And some of you have learned to read by Mrs. Kula as well. Mrs. Kula has given you the greatest gift that anybody has ever given you. And she has done this for 42 years. She has taught children how to read. That's over 1,000 children know how to read because of Mrs. Kula.
still understand that I've seen that, but I won't mention any names. But I'm very pleased to be here tonight. I'm honored to be able to give this speech to our graduating class. I'm sure, like Mrs. Gluck, a number of our other teachers, there are eighth graders up here who had us as students. We had their siblings, and in many cases, we had their parents as well. And as my wife likes to remind me, and perhaps all too often, this puts me in the vintage category. But before I begin my address, I'd like to take a few minutes to say that it's been my privilege to teach in a public school for 36 years. Our public school and public education system is truly the last institution in our country with a mission and an expectation to serve all of our citizens, all of our students who come to our doors. And during this time, I've been honored to work with many wonderful board members, many wonderful administrators, incredible faculty, staff, and parents who have dedicated themselves to the task of teaching our children. As I stand up here in front of this audience, in front of our graduates, our staff, and families, I'm reminded of a quote by the Vermont educator and author, Dorothy Canfield Fisher, who wrote this about public schools. More than just reading and writing was accomplished by the Vermont Schoolhouse. To sit together in a classroom is a social contract, and not just with those present in the schoolhouse, with their families too, and with most people in the town. Now if you're like me, you like to hear quotes twice, I'm gonna read this again because I think it's an important one. More than just reading and writing was accomplished by the Vermont Schoolhouse. To sit together in a classroom is a social contract, and not just with those present in the schoolhouse, but with their families and most people in the town. To me, this quote exemplifies the power of public education and the power of the St. Johnsbury school system to bring all of us together, you, the audience, our staff, these fine young adults in front of you for the common good. And like those students mentioned in Fisher's quote, when these students, to my left, enter school, they enter into a social contract by working together, by solving problems, by learning, by helping each other, by succeeding, and now by graduating. To you, the graduates, I thought long and hard about what I was going to say tonight, and in the end, I just couldn't resist giving one last sign. And I apologize because I think technology is wonderful, but it has its limits. And I believe our limits are the lightning and the cord here. And we can only manage to do these two monitors, so I apologize. You can't see those, but I believe as long as our graduates can see it, that's the most important part. So like every generation that has come before you, yours is facing with many challenges. Some seem beyond the solution. Unsolvable. When you're listening, watching, or reading the news, it can be something of an ordeal, and it's easy to become overwhelmed. But tonight I want to share with you a positive story. A positive story about an environmental problem that was solved by young people like you, by scientists, and by governments. It starts with this slide right here, which is an ozone bomb. Now, ozone is a molecule that is made up of three hydrogen atoms, unlike the oxygen which we breathe, which is made up of two oxygen atoms. Normally, it resides in a layer of our atmosphere that's somewhere between 6 miles up all the way up to 30 miles above the Earth's surface. And these ozone molecules, like the picture that we have up here, play a very critical role in our supply on Earth. They block ultraviolet radiation that comes streaming in from the sun. Not all of it, but a good deal of it. Without these ozone molecules, we, along with a lot of other living organisms, would find survival on Earth extremely difficult. So in the 1980s, scientists discovered that the ozone layer above the North and South Pole was disappearing. And the cause of this was CFCs, or they're called chlorofluorocarbons, but CFCs is a lot easier to remember. These were a human-made product. They were gas that had been created for refrigerators, freezers, air conditioners, various other applications. And they were wonderful in what they did, but unfortunately, when they leaked out of refrigerators, freezers, and whatever else they were used for, they moved up through the atmosphere into the ozone layer and were destroying these ozone molecules, causing them to break apart so they could no longer block the ultraviolet light. So scientists were concerned. This was potentially a huge problem for planet Earth and its inhabitants. But citizens, scientists, governments from around the world recognized the problem, and they began to work together to find a solution. So if you look at this graph, I know it might be hard to follow, but you'll notice that the levels are going up and up, and then around 1990, they begin to drop. So the question is, what happened? Well, what happened was, governments from around the world, scientists from around the world began to work together. They began to talk, they began to listen, they began to recognize the problem. Ultimately, they met up in Montreal, and they signed a protocol. It was called the Montreal Protocol, which banned the sale and manufacture of these CFCs. At the same time, scientists who had been working at these companies were making these CFCs. They began to come up with alternative products that weren't as harmful to our ozone layer. And in slide 3, you can see that line going dropping way off is the amount of CFCs being produced in the world, and it falls from that. So, why did I tell you this story? I wanted to show you, as young adults, that even our most challenging problems, no matter what they are, can be solved when people work together, when people collaborate, when people listen to one another, and when people work toward a common goal. And so I urge you, as we move on from the St. John's Grade School, to keep this in mind, that even our most challenging problems, no matter what they may be, can be solved when people listen, when people collaborate, when people work and move toward a common goal. Finally, my last part of the class, that's what you get on graduation, lots of points. And it echoes somewhat what Mrs. Baldock said. And my advice is this: you live in one of the most beautiful parts of the world. You may not realize that, but there are a lot of people who travel here to work at it. Experience it in real life, okay? Go outside at night and smell a lilac. Feel the wind on your face, the top down. Taste the late summer blackberry. Hear a hermit thrush falling on an early summer morning. Or see a beautiful moonrise over a snow-covered field. But whatever it is, take time to experience this beautiful place of fall. Best wishes to you, and thank you.
And then we're going to celebrate together in one loud raise the roof.
cheer for these guys, because they deserve it. So Mr. O'Farrell, please come up.
Elizabeth Bacon. Jacob H. Baseman. Sophia Farron. Braden Webster Beck. Isabella Claire Bostick. Isabel Ila Bourgeois. Evan A. Bracken. Molly Brennan. Tanner Bridges. Noah David Thrill. Timothy J. Michael DeGrandi.
Isadora Pinkstein. Emily Rose Doyle. Gavin Dufour. Logan Usalt. Haley Evans. Hannah Ray Perry. Charlie Flanders. Travis J. Forbes. Gavin Matthew Gaffori. Haley J. Gilmore. Ethan Jeffrey Gould. Meadow Isabella Hamilton. Riley Madison Harmon. Jeffrey Hopper. Hannah Marie Hayes. Aaliyah Hill. Aaliyah Jasmine Hooker. Devin James John. Emerson Abby John. Chandler Labonte. Rain Elizabeth LaForce. Connor Harrison Ladd. Nicholas A. Lampier. J. Brandon Scott Langman. Jacob D. McLaren. Kelsey Liberty. Cameron R. Little. Ben Lyons. Alexis G. Marr. Malcolm Maloney. Sierra Manassa Kernan. Jesse Marchbanks. Catherine Mastriani Douglas. Elizabeth Mastriani Douglas. Kathleen Mariah Mayhew. Dale S. McGinnis. Brianna Elizabeth McKinstry. Isaac Stephen Meisel. Shane Daniel Miller. Lucas Morris. Dacia Marie Forbes. Ayanna Marie Moses. Hayden Fitzpatrick Murphy. Matthew J. Newland. Brianna Marie Patton. Haley Miranda Perkins. Jonah E. Fossett. Emma Lee Powers. Isaiah Michael Priest. Mason Alice Rivers. Lizzie Sky Shad. Kobe Jacob Wanger Soltrude. Richard James Zorro. Anthony Charles Spalding. Gabriel Stanziano. Ryan P. Sullivan. Brody Jackson Taylor. Lily Grace Carrion. Colton Thomas. Ezra Wilson. Please join me in congratulating the class of 2000.
Everything you can to make something of yourself. Do something you can to change the world, even if that means